Hey guys, I already announced it in my holiday greetings. Every retro YouTuber needs a project. And even if he only has 50 subscribers. And here is mine, the USB RetroArdo input. It was 2020, and somebody in China experienced that you should enjoy barbecue bat only well done, not medium rare. And so, after work time quickly became very boring. Time to refresh my programming skills that became quite rusty during 15 years in satellite transmission and broadcast system integration, but also to explore new fields like PCB design and 3D printing. 2 years, a bunch of filament spools, and some orders at Chinese video sponsors later, I finally had this on my table. The idea was simple stupid. Solutions to use old computers on HDMI monitors already exist enough. Now we need something for USB input devices. Not only because old input devices tend to fail, but also because it's very comfortable and you can build a whole KVM only based around HDMI and USB. Inspiration, as well as the first source code snippets, came from Adrian Black from Adrian's Digital Basement and his PS2 to Tandy keyboard adapter. Platform for this project is likewise Adrian's, an Arduino, but it's a Mega with USB host shield. The project is full open source and Arduino sketch, case and PCB can be found in my GitHub, link in the video description. The documentation also contains a bill of materials. Most parts can be sourced without problems internationally via Mauser or in Germany via Reichelt. Just take care to get the right potentiometer with 100 kOhms. For example, Reichelt only supplies the version with 10 kOhms. Also for operations with a Tandy 1000, a 5-pin keyboard connector should be enough. If you want an 8-pin keyboard connector, Mauser has an undefined lead time and a minimum order amount of 8000. German online store Restore Store still has such connectors, but also their supply seems to deplete. So here it is, the USB RetroArdo input. My personal color scheme resembles the old IBM PCs with light gray front, mid gray case, red switches and black rear panel. On the left side, we find the Arduino USB port, a power jacket and a USB host port. Due to the way the host shield is made, this sits a little bit recessed. On the back side, we find an analog joystick port for PC and potentially also for Tandy and BBC Micro, an RS-232 mouse port, digital joystick for C64, Amiga and Atari, and an Atari Amiga mouse port. On the right side, we find a 5-pin or optionally, like here, 8-pin keyboard connector, a 6-pin mini-DIN for PS2 mouse, and a 4-pin mini-DIN for ADB. On the right side, we find the keyboard mode select switches. The lower switch selects between PC80 and XT, or if the mid switch is selected, between Apple and Amiga. The upper switch cap is quite hefty, as it changes 5 switches, which also change the pinout of the keyboard connector to Tandy. In the middle row, the upper switch changes the serial mouse between 2-button Microsoft and 3-button Logitech mode. The middle one selects if the digital joystick port reacts to a mouse or joystick, and the lower one selects between Amiga and Atari mouse pinout. The left switches pull the output of the analog pots to ground, which might be required for BBC or Tandy. Okay, enough theory, time for some practice. We start with an XT class machine and a USB composite hit, meaning mouse and keyboard operating over one wireless dongle. The keyboard already shows off while loading Qt Mouse. Here we see Qt Mouse is loading in Microsoft mode, so with 2 buttons. So let's unload the driver, and on the RetroArdo input we flip the mouse mode switch and firmly press the reset button. And now the driver loads in Logitech mode, which is 3 buttons. To finally check the function, let's run mouse test. Although many XT keyboards didn't bring an inverse T cursor pad, the XT actually supported it and it's implemented here, working independently from the numlock status of the numpad. Time to step up into the 80 class. Here everything is a little bit more complicated as a bidirectional host device communication was implemented. Among others, the keyboard LEDs are no longer set by the keyboard itself, but by the computer. And what's better to test the mouse than good old solitaire? On the 386, Commander Keen can show how good he can deal with USB keyboards. But on the 386, we also get the colorful AMI BIOS, which supports setting the keyboard tapmatic rate. This defines the behavior of the first and following repeats when the key is kept pressed. The parameters are set in the BIOS and sent via host to device command to the keyboard, or in our case to the retro ADO input. This is then responsible to deliver the right repeat rates. Now something that unfortunately doesn't work too well, the PS2 mouse. Currently nothing is connected and we see that IRQ12 is assigned to some plug and play card. Now we connect the retro ADO input via PS2 and see that IRQ12 is gone, so it is assigned to the PS2 port, a clear sign that the handshake with the BIOS works properly. Sometimes the Logitech driver works, but in time for presentation it stopped working. Qt Mouse and Windows also don't work, so I assume some timing issues. Switching on a Mac via ADB already works. The print screen key was misused as a power switch. However, I receive a lot of ADB communication requests from the Mac, but the replies the retro ADO input sends are obviously not the right ones. So unfortunately, the mouse doesn't work and keyboard implementation is still pending. Now back to something that works perfectly. The joystick. Supported are 4 axes and 4 buttons. The 2 axes are controlled via 2 DS18030 digital potentiometers and the buttons are triggered by pulling to ground. One remark, as I cannot read out the hit descriptor, each joystick has to be programmed separately and selected manually in the source code. The currently supported joysticks are defined in the globals.h and before compiling and uploading get selected in the globals.c. Currently supported a standard joystick, which mainly gives the same data packages as the SpeakLink Phantom Hawk. However, I remapped 2 Phantom Hawk buttons to be more natural and implemented a calibration routine for this particular joystick at its very poorly centered. The SpeedLink Competition Pro is the only joystick that crashes from time to time, however I'm not sure if it's the joystick or my programming. The Logitech Extreme 3D Pro works absolutely fine. Just like the Thrustmaster Airbus Sidestick, which became my favorite joystick, as you can mechanically lock out the twist axis. For the Logitech F310 and F710 gamepads, you need to consider that they need to be set in direct input mode, not in X input mode. Also, the recognition of the F710's wireless dongle is a little bit wonky. You might need to reset the retro ADO input a few times. And just because I had it here, I implemented the Trio Linker Plus. It has profiles for all three supported game controllers. As I don't own a GameCube controller, I made the assumption that it's identical to the PlayStation controller, which was successfully tested. Also, the Dreamcast controller works with the Trio Linker. Also, the digital joystick port for the Amiga works properly. Here, a dead zone was implemented. This ensures that an analog joystick doesn't trigger immediately after the smallest movement, but also doesn't wait until the minimum or maximum. Buttons are implemented with button 1 and 2 only. Also, the mouse does what it should, including support for 3 mouse buttons. And now it's getting totally wild. The Amiga keyboard support was developed with the A2000 in mind. But as I don't have one, I needed to wire up the A500, which uses the same protocol. All keys are working with the A500. However, due to the different layout, I had to remap some. The remappings can be found in the documentation on GitHub. The only thing the A2000 does different than the A500 is the keyboard reset routine. The A2000 routine was implemented at best guess and should work. The A500 reset routine was also left in the source code. I hope it doesn't interfere. My perfect me would surely have said, finish it. But due to lack of time and fluctuating workload in my daily job, this might have taken forever. As the status quo is already quite usable for many cases, I have decided to publish it and continue working and also rely on you, the community. So trust me, I will continue working on it, but if you have an idea how to fix the problems, feel free. So let's summarize again, what's hot, what's not. On the USB side, regular keyboards and mice work without problems. This also includes USB composite hits from wireless sets. Also various joysticks work good, but limitations apply. What doesn't work are USB gaming keyboard and mice that operate outside the USB hit specifications. This could either mean high sample rate or RGB lighting effects. Also, PlayStation and Xbox USB controllers are not implemented. The analog PC joystick port is working properly. Whether my idea works to make it running with a TRS-80 COCO or 10D1000 or BBC Micro needs to be tested. The serial mouse port supplies working protocols for 2-button and 3-button mouse. The Amiga Atari mouse port was tested on an Amiga, however I could not test the Atari pinout. And there might be even a chance to use it on PCs that use 2-bit gray code, like Bus Mouse or the Head Start Explorer. The digital joystick port is working properly. Just for fun, I made a selection if it should react to a joystick or a mouse, which makes it a 1350 Joy Mouse in case you want. However, I cannot seriously test this. A 1351 proportional mouse is not implemented. Maybe this comes in future releases. On the keyboard connector, we have a working XT protocol, a close to fully working AT and PS2 protocol. There are only from time to time issues setting the keyboard LEDs, but even typematic rate setting works. A properly working protocol for Amiga 500 and 2000. And the 10D1000 protocol, which I have taken over from Adrian Black, adapting it to USB. As I don't have a 10D1000, I cannot test this adaption. The PS2 port, I already have seen it working, but it obviously has some timing issues. Sometimes it works with certain drivers, sometimes not. The ADB port is simply not ready, implementation ongoing. And what are my future plans for the platform? Level 1, surely make it fully working. Level 2, build a modular version, the RetroADO Input Modular. Level 3, migrate to new platforms like Arduino Duo or Raspberry Pi with Piduino. Level 4, the Retro KV Gem, meaning keyboard, video, joystick, audio and mouse. I hope you enjoyed it, leave a like and subscribe also to push this project, and see you in the next video.